So, today, we'll solve the third and fourth items sa double integration. And then hopefully sa next week natin, we can solve this using area moment na. Now for the beam shown daw, determine the slope at point C and also the deflection at point C. Yan. So, recall lang natin, dapat yung cut natin must be sa before sa last point ng segment, ng pinakalast na segment. So, segment BC, yung cut pala natin must be right here. Yan. And then all loads must be continuous up to the cut. So, dapat itong 500 Newton per meter pala na loading ng triangle, it must go up to the cut. Now, since naputol yan siya sa point B, then we have to make this load continuous. To make this continuous, we have to extend this one, ito, extend natin up to the cut. So, dapat yung height ng triangle pala, andito sa cut natin. So, extend lang natin to. Yan. So, we have to add a load para maging continuous siya. So, kulayan lang natin ng ito na lang, green. So, extend natin siya up to the cut. Yan. Now, to obtain this height, we have to apply ratio and proportion talaga. And then, since nag-add tayo ng di ba, pwede kayan siyang isulat dyan. This is downward. So, yung dinagdag natin na load is, di ba, trapezoidal yung shape niya. Yang dinagdag natin, trapezoidal. So, our counteracting load must also be trapezoidal din. Yan. So, gagawin natin, add tayo ng load sa ilalim for our counteracting load. Yan. And then, dapat trapezoidal din yung shape niya. So, parang paganto. Yan. Now, let's just make it more realistic. Dapat same height siya. Yan. Check natin na. And then, ito rin dapat same height siya sa height dito. So, bawasan na lang natin unti. Yan. So, ito na yung counteracting load natin. By the way pala, we have to first solve the reactions of the beam. So, copy ko muna yan. And then, sa pag-solve ng reactions, pwede mong i-disregard muna lang yung naging continuous na nga loads. Yung original loading lang yung i-consider natin. Yan. So, solving the reactions, diba sa point A, meron tayong vertical reaction, AY, saka sa point B din. Yan. Meron din tayong AX dito, kaso walang horizontal load, so it will just be 0. Yan. Now, to get AY, I can take moments about point B. So, summation of moments tayo about point B. We have AY multiplied by 3 meters. Yan yung ano niya, perpendicular distance. And then, yung resultant ng triangle, pwede natin kunin. So, it will have a resultant acting right here. Now, this is 1/3 of the base going to the height. So, 1/3 ng 3. And then yung value niya is yung area ng load. So since this is triangular, 1 half pala times the base na 3 meters multiplied by a height of 500 newton per meter. Yan. So magka-cancel yung meter, and then multiplying all of these magiging 0.5 multiplied by 3 then times 500. So 750 pala. This is newtons. So AY multiplied by 3, and then the moment this will cause about point B is counterclockwise. So we have to use minus, then 750, multiply natin by 1/3 of 3. Pwede mong lagyan ng 1, but ito na lang para mas comprehensive. I mean, comprehensible pala. So set ko yan to 0. So I have 3x minus 750. Remove mo na lang yan kasi magka-cancel lang din naman yung 3. So equals 0. So AY pala is 250. Naka-Newton yan. And then to solve BY naman, we can just sum up forces vertical. So we have 250 minus 750 plus BY equal dapat yan to 0. So BY is ano pala? I can just move the constant term sa kabilang side ng equation. So it will be 750 minus 250. So meron tayong 500 pala. Wait lang. 500, yes. This is newtons. Yan. So meron na tayong reactions, we can now solve we can now form the moment equation. Dapat singular moment equation, isang moment equation lang for the whole span. Yan, so sulat natin ulit yung reactions dito. So this is 250 ito naman 500 yan. So gagawin natin para ma check natin right away, imo-model muna natin yung beam. So ano din pala, I invite everyone na i-download yung app na to. Kasi this is very helpful sa mechanics saka structural theory. So yan. Let's model the beam. So we have a span of 4 meters, 3 plus 1. So gawin natin 4. Then meron tayong hinge dito sa ka-roller at 3 meters. So lagay ko 3, and then we have a triangular load. Now to form a triangular load, wait lang, medyo naglalag siya, kailangan siyang i-close. So, ito. Ito yung distributed load natin. Yan. Extend mo lang yan up to 3 meters. Kasi diba dyan siya nag-terminate. Then, 500 newton per meter. Gawin na lang natin 500 kilonewton per meter. Hindi naman mag-change yung sagot natin. And then, for the other side, dapat 0 yan siya. For triangular loads. So, from 0 up to 500. Uniformly increasing. Yan. So, ito yung reactions natin. 250 at this point, and then at this point naman, 500 kilonewtons. So, tama lang to. Yung reactions natin. Now, ito dapat yung value ng C1 natin. I mean, C2 must be 0. And then, C1 natin must be ito. But this must be 10,000 pala. For a while, ah. Yan, ito dapat yung value ng C1 natin. So, let's try to check. Again, ha? Yung value ng C1, yan yung slope sa pinaka-left na end. And then, yung value naman ng C2, yan yung deflection at the left end. So, if merong support sa left end, walang value yung C2. Automatic. And then, kung merong fixed support sa left end, automatic, walang value si C1. Kasi yung slope dyan is 0. So, review lang tayo sa na-discuss natin kahapon. So, now, let's form the singular moment equation. Now, we have EI y prime prime. Yan. So, to solve this, diba, we have a triangular load for the top side, but yung nasa ilalim, naka-trapezoidal kasi siya. So, we have to divide this load into two. Bala, isang triangular, isang rectangular. So, let's first get the height at this point, yung height ng triangle. So, label na lang natin siya as y. Yan. So, ano daw yung y? Now, mangyayari dito is, let's consider the whole triangle. Yan. So, we have y is to a base of 3 plus 1, 4 meters. So, y is to 4. Equals, eto, 500 yung height at this point. So, 500 divided by a distance of 3 meters. Yan yung base. So, divided by 3. Now, we have x over 4 equals 500 over 3. Masosolve na natin yung height at this point. So, our height pala is 666.67 approximately. Now, this is Newton per meter. So, itong height pala na to, yung buong height na yan, is also 666.67. However, we have to divide this load into 2. So, bale pala, let's draw a line here. Yan. Broken line lang. Now, diba, we have a uniform load, rectangular load, and a triangular load. Now, ano yung height na to? Yung height ng load na to. Wait lang. Yan. Yung height ng load na to is also 500 newton per meter. So, lagay ko 500. So, the height of the triangular load pala, this one, is 666.67 minus 500. So, we have 166.67. Yan. So, we have the height of the triangular load. Meron din tayong height ng uniform load, which is 500 lang. So we have to separate the two. Now again, the distance x must be measured from the left end. So from here, patungo sa cut, label ko siya as x. Yan. So taking moments about the cut, yung naka sky blue, we have ito, 250 multiplied by x. Yan. How about for the triangular load? Review natin yung nasa shear moment equation na discussion natin. So what if we have this span and then we have a triangular load? Yan. Let's just say na this has a magnitude of 10 kilonewton per meter and a base of 3 meters lang. Yan. Now what if I want to cut at this point, at any point na nasa gitna ng triangle? Let's say dito. Yan. Notice that the height of the triangle varies with the distance. Kasi, let's say, ito yung x ko. Yan. Diba, if x increases, the height also increases. Kasi this is uniformly varying. So, pag yung x ko andito na, yan, ito na naman yung height. So, nag-increase siya from this one. So, we have to define the height pala in terms of the distance x. Kasi diba, sa shear moment equation, yung independent variable natin must be x. So now, we have our resultant force right here. Just considering the cut and then considering natin yung left side. Now, the value of the resultant is 1/2 times, sabi natin, x yung height, yung base, height naman is y. Sabihin lang natin. So, 1/2 times x multiplied by y. Yan yung value ng resultant. Area ng triangle. Yan. By the way ha, itong triangle lang muna. Yan. Yung nasa pat. Now, our moment arm naman, patungo sa cut natin, is, diba, 1/3 of x or 1/3 of the base. Kasi this is a triangular load. So, this is x divided by 3. Yan. But we have two variables, we have x and y, so we have to define y in terms of x. So mangyayari, let's just use ratio and proportion. So we have a height of 10, yan, divided by a base of 3 meters, equal yan to this smaller triangle. I-consider natin yan, so it has a height of y and a base of x. Therefore pala, y in terms of x is y equals 10/3 multiplied by x. If i-multiply natin yung x sa kabilang side. Yan. But more generally, we can transform this parang, diba, we are relating y over x to the height of the triangle, yung magnitude talaga, divided by the base. Now, if the if the degree increases, yung degree ng x or yung base mag-increase din. So bale, to make a more streamlined equation pala, we can add n and then dito rin. So y in terms of x for any loading, be it triangular loading or loading na spandrel yung shape, we have y equals h over b to the n multiplied by x to the n. Now, for triangles, the degree is 1. So, walang magbabago dyan. Yung b to the 1 saka x to the 1, walang magbabago. But if you have a spandrel load or a parabolic load, then just replace n by the degree of the load. So, ito lang yung shortcut natin for y in terms of x. Yan. Now, if I will take moments about the cut, then I have the resultant 1 half times x times y, so 1 half xy multiplied by x divided by 3 or 1 third of x. Yan. But I have to replace y by this one. So, bale pala 1 half times x. And then, ito na lang yung i-consider natin. So, 10 third multiplied by x, then multiplied by x divided by 3. Ito pala yung way to get moments if meron kang triangular load. So, medyo nag-review lang tayo sa mechanics yung shear moment equation natin. So, then we have this expression, 250 multiplied by x, and then move na lang natin to kasi kailangan natin yung space. Yan. So, 250 multiplied by x, then we have, let's consider this triangle muna. Now, wag mo siyang i-separate na itong triangle, I mean, wag mo itong i-separate. Just consider the whole triangle kasi ginawa natin yan siyang continuous, so it just acts like a triangular load over the whole span. So ito lang yung gawa natin ng moment equation. Now, the height at this point is 666.67. So mangyayari, it will cause a counterclockwise rotation about our moment center. So we have to use minus. Then it has a resultant of ano bang kulay yung resultant? Ano na lang? Ano ba yung hindi nagamit? Purple na lang. Yan, so parang meron siyang resultant na 1 half multiplied by x multiplied by y, then moment arm niya is x divided by 3. Yan. So, minus 1 half multiplied by x, and then again, ito yung shortcut ng y natin in terms of x. So, lagay ko na lang siya dyan. Now, again, h and b are constant values based on the figure talaga. So, h is the height of the triangle. So, 666.67. Yan. Then, divided by b to the n, the whole base of this triangle is 3 plus 1. So, magiging 4. So, 4 to the n, meron kang 1 dyan. Pwede mo na lang hindi na isulat. But, if the degree is 2, let's say spandrel yung load, then you have to include 2 dyan. And then multiplied by x, still x to the 1, so walang magbabago. Yan. And then don't forget the moment arm, x divided by 3. Yan. So, tapos na tayo sa reaction, tapos na din tayo sa triangle na to, yung buo. So, yung kulang na lang is for the 500 newton load and this trapezoidal load. So, lagay natin, this will cause a clockwise rotation about the moment center. So, plus pala 500 multiplied by its moment arm. Now, the moment arm of the 500 newton load going to the cut is x minus 3. Kasi diba, yung 500 newton load, ito lang yung moment arm niya. So, yung buong distance na x, bawas natin yung 3 meters na distance. Lagyan lang natin ng arrowheads. Yan. So, x minus 3. And then, since meron siyang minus, dapat, we have to use pointed brackets. So, ito pala. X minus 3. Yan. Then, dapat, i-multiply natin siya sa... okay na pala to. This is a concentrated load pala. Akala ko yung distributed load. So, disregard lang natin. Yan. 500 times X minus 3. The next, let's consider the uniform load. Ito, di ba, uniform load, we split this into two. So, uniform load and a triangular load. Now, for the uniform load, the height is 500 newton per meter. Itong height na to. Yan. Now, it will cause a clockwise moment naman. So, we have to use plus. Kasi this is directed upward to counteract what we added. So, plus. Then, we have to check ano yung base ng rectangular load. So, di ba, the base of the rectangular load is still x minus 3. Ito. So, ano pala? 500 newton per meter multiplied by x minus 3. Yan yung resultant load. Bala, resultant load of the uniform load. Parang 500 multiplied by x minus 3. And then, its moment arm naman going to the cut is 1/3 of x minus 3. So, x minus 3 divided by 3. I mean, sorry. Akala ko yung triangle. Ano pala? X minus 3 divided by 2. Kasi half lang. Uniform load kasi nasa gitna yung centroid niya. So, x minus 3 divided by 2. Yan. For a while lang. Yan. So, tapos na tayo sa 500 newton load saka sa uniform load. Dito na naman tayo sa triangular load. So, for the triangular load, it will still cause a clockwise moment. So, plus pa rin. Then, our area is ito. Merong resultant dyan for the triangular load. So, this is 1/2 multiplied by the base. Again, the base will not be x kasi x minus 3 yan. Applied kasi siya dito. From this point lang. So, 1/2 times x minus 3 multiplied by y. Yung y natin must be ito yung form niya. So, h over b to the n multiplied by x to the n. Now, yung height saka base, again, constant term sila. So, ano yung height ng triangle? Height ng triangle is 166.67. Yan. Ano naman yung base? Base ng triangle is only 1 meter. Kasi ito lang yung triangle natin. So, divided by 1. Then, x naman natin, again, ito, must be the same sa figure. So, x minus 3 yung base ng triangle. So, this must also be x minus 3. Yan. So, ito yung resultant force natin. And then, moment arm naman niya, going to the cut, is 1/3 of x minus 3. So, x minus 3 divided by 3. Yan. So, sulat natin lahat. We have this force multiplied by the moment arm. So, 1/2. Use pointed brackets kasi merong minus sa function natin. Yan. Then, times 166.67. Lagay muna natin yung divided by 1 but eliminate na lang natin mamaya. Then, x minus 3 multiplied by x minus 3 divided by 3. Yan. So, medyo mahaba yung ano talaga natin. Yung equation. Moment equation. But, we can simplify this by joining the repeating terms. Gawin natin tong x minus 3 squared. Ito naman, tatlong instances ng excuse me. Tatlong instances ng x minus 3. Gawin na lang natin x minus 3 tas cube. So, copy natin to ulit. Ayan. So, this is still EI Y prime prime. Now, ito, tatlong instances ng X. Yan. So, gawin na lang natin X cube. And then, let's just multiply all the denominators. Yung terms dyan. So, this will now reduce into X cube bala na ano na lang. Remove ko na lang yan. Again, tatlong X and then 2 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3. Ano yan? 24. So, minus 1 over 24. Then, copy mo yan. 666.67 multiplied by x cube. Then, plus this one. And then, ito. Dalawang x minus 3. Gawin na lang natin x minus 3 tas squared. Yan. Now, pwede mo rin i-divide yung 500 sa 2. Bala, 250 na yan. But again, ako, to reduce errors sa calculations, later ko na lang sinisimplify. And then, we have this one. So, tatlong x minus 3. So, gagawin natin. Highlight ko ah. Yan, silang tatlo. Then, yung nasa denominator naman, 2 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 3. So, magiging 6. So, divided by 6. Then, 166.67. Tas x minus 3 then cube natin. Now again ha, merong checking for the singular moment equation. Substitute mo lang yung value ng buong span. Pag mag 0 siya, then it means na tama yung singular moment equation mo, given na walang applied moment sa pinaka right na end. So yan lang yung isang consideration mo dyan. So, input daw natin. 250x, eto, minus 666.67 divided by 24, tas x cube plus 500 multiplied by x minus 3. Yan. Then, plus 500 multiplied by x minus 3 then square divided by 2 ito na. Then finally we have plus 166.67 x minus 3 then cube divided by 6. So press calc, input natin yung distance ng buong beam. So, 3 plus 1 magiging 4. So, input natin yan. So, upon pressing 4, we get a value of minus 8.33 times 10 to the negative 3. Now, this is virtually 0. Now, hindi lang siya nag-0 exactly kasi yung ginamit natin na value is rounded up. Ito. Diba, 666 non-terminating yan dapat. But, ginawa kasi natin 0.67. So, pag i-check mo yan, yung value niya talaga, just press shift, then mode, then norm, 8, input mo, 2. Yan. So, ito talaga yung value niya. So, parang 0 na talaga yan siya. So, ibig sabihin, tama na yung moment equation natin. So, pag tama na yung moment equation mo, pag nag-0 siya, by inputting the whole span of the beam, then you can proceed to developing your slope equation and the next, your deflection equation. Always check talaga from the moment equation pa lang. Yan yung ginagawa ko dati sa undergrad. Especially pag merong quiz na merong time constraint. So para hindi na ako mag-review, I will review each step of the way na lang. Yan. So now, we can integrate. Diba, if we'll integrate this function, we can get the slope equation. So now, this becomes y prime prime. Integrate mo yan once, magiging EI y prime. So, proceed tayo. We have 250. Ito, magiging x squared divided by 2. Then we have minus 666.67 plus 1 sa exponent, magiging x to the 4th divided by 24 multiplied by the new exponent. So, multiplied by 4. Yan. Then, plus 500 multiplied by x minus 3. Square na yan kasi meron siyang 1 dyan. 1 plus 1, 2. Divided by 2. Then, plus ito ulit. Copy ko na lang. Yan. Ito, magiging cube. Then, multiplied by 3. Then, copy ko na lang din to. So, 3 plus 1, magiging 4. And then, yung nasa ilalim must be multiplied by 4, the new exponent. Kasi diba, ito yung i-divide natin using the power rule. Now, since nag-integrate na tayo one time, merong lalabas na isang arbitrary constant. So, let's name it C1. Yan. Now, itong C1, it must have a value kasi at point A or the left end, wala kasing fixed support. So, pag walang fixed support, C1 must have a value. Pero pag meron naman, automatic yan, 0 na yan. Saka yung C2 din. So, finally, we have the deflection equation. Yan. So, we have integrate this once more, magiging EI y. Yan. So, meron na tayong 250 plus 1 dyan, cube, divided by 2, multiplied by 3, then minus, copy ko na lang, and then this now becomes 5, then multiply din tayo ng 5 sa ilalim. Then, ito rin. Cube na yan. And then, 2 multiplied by 3. Ito naman. Plus 500 x minus 3. This becomes 4. Then, 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 4. Then, this one naman. 5 na to. While this is multiplied by 5. And then, ito, madudugtungan na siya ng x. So, plus C1x. Then, plus another arbitrary constant kasi dalawang beses na tayo nag-integrate. So, plus C2. Yan. So, meron na tayong deflection equation saka slope equation. And then, we can automatically assume na C2 is 0. Kasi, boundary conditions natin, again, mag-occur sa supports. So, at x equals 0, or dito sa left end, walang deflection na mangyayari. So, y equals 0 din. Now, pag lahat yan 0, lahat ng x mo, bala 0 yan, ito, magka-cancel yan lahat, saka ito rin. So, C2, essentially, just becomes 0 if y is also 0 sa left end. So, lagay na lang natin. For the boundary conditions at x equals 0, y equals 0, we can say that C2 equals 0. But again, yung C1 natin, magkaka-value And then, ito yung basehan natin. Yung roller support. So, for the roller support, this is at x equals 3, y equals 0. Kasi walang deflection na mangyayari sa support. So, ito pala yung boundary conditions natin. So, for the second boundary condition, copy ko na lang to. Diba, x equals 3, y equals 0. So, papalitan ko to ng 0. And then, lahat ng x, gagawin kong 3. But, take note, just eliminate all of these. Ito, ito, saka ito. Bakit? 3 minus 3, that just becomes 0. So, it's futile to include these sa equation mo. Ito na lang. Yung merong x lang. Kasi again, yung nasa loob niyan, it cannot be 0 or it cannot be a negative value. If you are trying to solve for these constants. So, itong C2, 0 na yan. Now, let's try to solve C1. So, input natin. Now, ginagawa ko dati, diba, to solve C1x, then we can just transfer that sa kabilang side ng equation, or simply, ito na lang, yung constant term niya, imu-move natin sa kabilang side ng equation, tas divide natin by x. So, essentially, C1 is the negative of this result. Sabihin na lang natin na ano ba? C na lang. Constant. Divided by x. So again, itong C is the result pag gumamit tayo ng calc. So we have negative of 250 x cubed divided by 2 multiplied by 3, that becomes 6. Then minus 666.67, then x to the 5, then 24 times 4 multiplied by 5. So ito lang, then divide natin by x, for which x is nakabase sa limit mo. So x equals 3. So press equals, ito na yung ano natin, value ng C1. So check down natin. C1. Nako, dapat C1 is 262.5. Check muna natin kung saan tayo nagkamali. For a while, ah. Okay na to. 250x squared over 2, 3, 4, then 24 times 4, 2, 2, 3, then 6, 4, then 6 times 4. Plus C1. Ito, 3, then 2 multiplied by 3, 5, ito, 3, 2 multiplied by 3, 4, then ito, plus 166.67 x minus 3, 5, then 6 times 4 times 5. Saan kaya nagkamali? Double check ko, 250 x cubed over 6, -666.67 x to the 5, then 24 times 4 times 5. Ah, ito pala. Sorry. Dapat calc then 3 pala. For yung input ko. So, C1 is -262, then 0.499, that's virtually 0.5. So, tama na. Diba, this is 262.5 then. So, yan yung slope. Diba, yung value ng C1 is the slope at the left end. So, ito. -262.5. So, lahat ng C1 dyan, papalitan natin. Now, our questions here are the following. First, ano daw yung slope at point C? Now, point C occurs at the free end. So, bala, at this point pala, x is equal to 4. So, ito yung isa-substitute natin sa slope equation saka deflection equation. Now, for the slope equation, copy lang natin to. Ayan. Then, C1 is already, meron na tayong value. So, -262.5. And then, lahat ng x natin must be 4 na dapat. Now, if 4 yung x, included lahat ng terms natin kasi 4 minus 3 gives us positive 1. So, dapat kasali na to. Now, just input the equation. So, 250x squared divided by 2, then -666.67 x to the 4th divided by 24 times 4, then plus 500 x minus 3 squared divided by 2 plus another 500 x minus 3 cubed, then divided by 2 multiplied by 3, then plus ito. So, hindi na kasha. So, gagawin ko na lang. I will just store this expression. Yan. Press equals. Lagay natin sa A. Then, after storing this, i-add natin to. So, A plus ito, 166.67 multiplied by x minus 3 to the 4th. Then, 6 multiplied by 4. Tas -262.5 for the value of C1. So, press equals. We have 299.997. So, let's try to check down. What is the slope at the free end? So, move natin yan. Notice na 300 talaga yung sagot. Positive 300. So, ibig sabihin, positive counterclockwise yung notation. So, lagay natin, y prime pala is, ano nga yan? 300. Unit natin is, naka-newton yung load natin, newton per meter. Ito, newton per meter. So, our unit must be newton m cubed divided by EI. Yan. So, positive counterclockwise yung slope. Yan. So, ito na yung sagot natin. Now, how about for the deflection at point C? For the deflection naman, we have to consult this equation. So, copy na lang natin. And then, ito, 0, C2, while C1 is minus 262.5. So gagawin natin, divide na lang din natin into 2 kasi hindi yan magkakasya sa calculator natin. So 250 x cube, still at x equals 4 tayo, divided by 6, then minus 666.67 x to the 5 divided by 24 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5 plus 500 x minus 3 then cube divided by 6 plus 500 then x minus 3 to the 4th divided by 2 times 3 times 4. Yan. Equals na lang. I mean, calc pala. Calc x equals 4. Yan. So, shift store. Lagay natin sa A. So, recall A. And then, plus 166.67 x minus 3 to the 5, then 6 times 4 times 5 minus 262.5 multiplied by x. Yan, so press calc. Ito yung A while x is still 4 kasi at x equals 4. So press equals, we still have 300 pa rin. Check down natin. Tama. Yan. 300 din. Now, 300,000 yan kasi hindi ko ginawang 10 million. 10 million kasi pag gusto mo yung deflection. So, eto. 300. So, y equals... by the way, slow pala to. This must be m squared pala. Sorry. So this is still 300 newton. M cubed na yan kasi deflection divided by EI. Now, positive yung lumabas. Ibig sabihin, the deflection pala is upward. Yan. So, pag i-check din natin yung elastic curve sa app. Yan. Diba, it moved upward at this point. So, kaya positive yung value ng deflection.